Hello everybody, sorry about all the noise and stuff. I'm uploading part one right now. So, we're gonna be starting How to Make an Elevator Animation Part 2. Utri, you can go do that in the basement.
This is where my goal is.
What?
This is where my goal is.
Can't you, like, make the alcove a goal?
What?
Can't you make the alcove a goal? So, we're gonna go in. Now, that was not needed.
What?
That loud smack was not needed.
I'm doing shots.
Alright, so I guess we're just gonna have to deal with that. So, this is part two. And part two will be drawing the elevator cab. So, as you know, we need to draw an elevator cab. So, the first step to drawing an elevator cab is to obviously get this.
Mom, it's past 6:15.
So the first step is to draw the door sensor and stuff. So, just kind of follow along with me. So, we'll bring the line over here, connect it up, and then we're ready to start drawing some of the parts. So, we will go ahead and draw a line straight across. And another line, 2 pixels below it, so they're not touching each other, but they're right below each other. Then after that, do the same towards the bottom. Okay, right now I was just... And I was just doing a length test.
Easy. Easy
peasy. Love
the easy move
because
you opened up.
And we got a... oops. Get on. Button. Little rosin, and then make a dark color for the shaft. And then there's our elevator shaft. Go and copy and paste this over. Tip, always paste at the top.
Oh, toe drag!
What?
Toe drag, look, toe drag.
I'm filming.
Okay.
I'm filming. But what happened? Hold on a second, guys. Then down the middle of the inside of the shaft, we gotta draw a small little rectangle. And
a few more for and then I'm gonna be done.
We gotta fill it in with a dark purple or whatever color you
get off of me.
And whatever color you want your door sensor to be. Then I have two little pixels that I need to remove. I'm gonna go ahead and remove those pixels. Can we go out?
No.
Why can't we go?
Oh, that's him. I don't know what he's doing. But he's not playing downtown, is that?
Is that what he said?
Huh?
Is that what he said?
Yeah. Well, he didn't say that.
Well, he didn't say it, but he would have said, if we were going to go downtown, he would have said, come down here. And he's like, I'm on my way home. So I'm close.
How long has it been hurting?
The mom.
What?
What exactly is he nervous about? Mom.
Hmm?
Like, what did you tell Drew?
He's trying to figure school out for you.
She told me that he's nervous because of everything that's happened at school.
Yeah.
Okay.
Even though I think he might be sick.
He is not sick, okay?
If he is, I'm going over to Mo's or Mo's house.
All right, so, not that long.
I'm hungry, and my stomach hurts.
Because you're hungry.
This
is common sense.
Where are we eating?
I don't know. Wait for Dad to get home.
Oh, Krita, come on. Don't bother me now. Same thing with you, brother. Yep, okay, I got the right color. So, I'm gonna go ahead and open up we wanna, save as first. 12. Just to make sure we have everything saved. So now what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to copy this elevator car. I'm going to open up a new paint window. And you have to do this without pressing the new button, because if you press the new button, it just closes down the one that you have open to a new one. So, now I got to decide where I want the walls to not be visible, because obviously you're not going to see part of the walls. So, I have to decide where I want that, and then I gotta copy that in and stuff, which is gonna be hard because I don't have Krita open layers and stuff, so, see, if Microsoft Paint had layers, it'd be a lot easier. So, I need to figure out where I want that. So go ahead and set your fill to solid color. And then decide where you want your wall to stop at. And where your wall stuff will be. So then we're going to paste another one of these elevator cars. And now what we gotta do is we have to draw the cab. So to draw the cab, what we're going to do here is
I'm really bored.
Something
I'm
that,
doing that all day.
This is something that I actually just thought of how to do, but it's a really useful technique that I just thought of. Hey Drew, you want to be in the video of me?
No.
Why not?
Because I only do elevator videos.
This is an elevator video.
I mean, like, riding on elevators.
And siren videos.
Yeah.
Wait, why didn't I just... I'm silly. I could have just, died all of that instead of cutting corners off.
This couch smells like cat pee.
Dexter? So, what we got here is we kind of got like something that allows me to draw the full cab over here, then transfer the whole cab over to here. But in a way, this is going to be kind of hard, but I just thought of a way though. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna draw a cab now. So, we gotta draw a middle part. Gotta make sure it's all centered. That's a big factor in drawing these cabs. Everything to be centered and symmetrical. So now that I just did that, oh, I still have a little bit of stuff over there. Now that I just did that, I have to copy and paste. Excuse me. So I just overdid by one pixel. Wait. Let me think for a second. So sometimes, Adrian, can you use earbuds, please, since I'm filming?
Yes.
Thank you. So, as you can see, this was dot-centered, so that's a very important factor, as you can tell. So, yeah. But now, what we gotta do is we have to... Actually, know what? We shouldn't have started with the square in the middle. Get rid of this stone here. I don't like that being there. So... Draw a line. Copy and paste. Whoops. See what I mean by this transparent selection tool? It's very useful and important to have enabled. Apparently, I have my door frame drawn unevenly. That brings a surprise to me. It should be fine, though. It shouldn't, like, it's one pixel, like, literally. So, So, now that we got that square drawn, what we gotta do, by the way, this is gonna be a long part, just to let you guys know, so go ahead and strap in. And, now we're gonna draw a square. And, so you can tell that this is like a rather long elevator cab. So, reason being for that is this rear door, that we're gonna have. So there's gonna be no rear control panel. So we could just draw our door line all the way down. Actually, I'm just gonna keep this one center slide. Actually, no, I want it to be signified as a door. So now what we want to do is we want to draw the, so here, gotta dye that, whoops, how did I manage to catch that one pixel? See, it took me like multiple tries to get it that time. That was weird. Then what we want to do is we want to draw the cab. Like the cab parts is what I'm saying. Because we're drawing the cab right now. We just gotta draw the cab's parts. So, let's say there's a display. Back. I mean on the side. Like a sign display. So. Now we can zoom back in and put a color in. Let's do color like red. Then the ceiling we're gonna keep white because that's gonna be the lights that will light up the elevator cab. So now we gotta draw the light separators. At least that's what I like to call them, because I don't know the actual name of them. Thank you. Sounds good. So now we got the white panel up on the top. Then we're just gonna dye that like that color right now. Actually, let's make it a color here. We'll just do some colors that don't like aggravate your mind. At least that don't aggravate my mind. They at least don't aggravate my mind. So, blue and pink is a kind of common combination to me, so I'm going to go ahead and use that. And, what? Oh, you look like you were nodding your head no.
Yeah.
That's where I gotta do the floor. The floor, huh? But the floor. What do I do for the floor? Flintstones. He has eyes closed. He's so cute. Let's see how my video upload's doing. I'm sorry, I gotta check on that. Yes, this is the right video. Publish, and everything's good here. Alright. Back to the video. So, I'll do floor like that kind of color. That's not noticeable enough. There we go. Dye that silver right there, since that's like a place that doesn't have a light. We'll go ahead and copy and paste it. I do need to copy this whole thing, I guess. I don't want to do that because of the deformed side. Okay, so now we have the elevator cab drawn. Now what we need to do is we need to, we need to keep transparent selection on. We select this door, right, this elevator door. And move it over top. Now, you do notice the labels are changing colors a bit. That will be fine. We can just fix that. Then we got a good elevator cab drawing. So, now please excuse me while I fix this, little problem here. So, yeah, I gotta fix these so they look right. Oop. So, now we finally have our elevator cab drawn, and it's been, a bunch of minutes. You can go ahead and dye this background, that color. Whatever color your regular wall is. So, I'll make it easier to copy and paste everything in. Now for pasting in, make sure you set your color suit to the wall color. Then you can set it back. Now, I need to use the restroom, so, I'll be right back. I can't pause in OBS Studio, sadly, so, I'll just set you guys right there. Alright, so I am back, and we can get back to the animation now. Drew, I'm trying to film, please. Let's see. Oh, also, just something to mention is that, have you ever seen the video where this woman goes like, moves her neck around, but without moving her face, so she's just like, so like, she'd be like this, but her neck would stay in one spot, so it would look like this, except for her face would be straight. It's really funny. So yeah, sorry, I had to look at the face cam to do that, like simulate it, so yeah, I definitely can't do that myself. Pixel, the imposter has arrived. There. So now we have the cap drawn. So it's been a pretty long video, so I'm just gonna wrap it up for this video. So yeah, that's gonna be it. So bye.